Welcome to the session of Masterstroke. In this Masterstroke, we are going to discuss about the challenges in DI. Before solving the DI caselet randomly of any of the type or based on the any type of data representation, first we should try to understand what are the challenges in DI. How to tackle the DI caselet? First is identification. If you are not able to identify the DI caselet, how you will able to solve? How you will make the strategy to approach? Then your challenges in DI, we will try to understand little bit in depth. What are the factors that is going to affect your performance in DI and how to encounter that factors? And based on that, how you will able to improve your accuracy also and your performance also. Means you can say how you will able to save the time and how you will able to increase your accuracy. These two are target. Time you have to reduce, accuracy you have to improve. These two are our main target for competitive examination. Here we are preparing this session, it is related to DI, then DI also will be same target. Time we should reduce, accuracy we should increase. Then how to increase the accuracy and how to reduce the time together, we have to just understand what are the challenges in DI. This is going to affect your all type of DI caselets, like type 1 to type 8, that is based on your tables. Type 1 is based on your tables and graph, type 2 is based on your set and subset, type 3 is based on the average and allegation. Like that, type 1 to type 8, all type of caselet, you can apply these concept, whatever we are going to discuss about the challenges in DI. Of course, it is going to affect your DI and LR section. Then without puzzling, just we'll try to move what are these challenges of DI. To understand the data given in any DI caselet and solve with approximately 85 plus percent of accuracy, around 80 to 85% minimum accuracy is needed. Like if 10 question you are attempting, then 8 question minimum should be correct. If it is going less than 8 question, then it is very difficult because negative marking also will be there. Then maybe you will attempt entire paper, you will not able to get the correct, you will not able to get the enough percentile to get the call letter for the good colleges. Then minimum 85% percentage of accuracy should be there. Means more than that, it is welcome. If you are solving with the rate of 90% accuracy, that is best. 95% accuracy, 100% accuracy, it is all the best. There is no issue. But minimum 80 to 85. Minimum 80. It should not fall down 80. Means you pick the question where you are having almost 80% confident, you will able to solve the question. That is another sense. Means once you are picking the question for round 1, that time almost 80% you are sure this question you are able to solve. Means your probability to solve this question is around 0.8 or 80%. Then accuracy, our target is around 85% or more than that, 85 plus. Within a stipulated time, time is not going to increase, time is fixed. That fixed time, how to utilize for different type of question and how you can increase your selection and rejection of the question. Means that a skill of selection and rejection. Means which question you should pick for round 1 and which question you should reject for round 1. Both you try to give more focus. Kya hame pick karna hai? Or kya reject karna hai? Dono equally important. Means this question, if you are just picking, okay, ye question main confident hu, ye question hame round 1 mein karna hi karna hai. But dusra question dekh rahe nahi, ye question thoda lengthy hai, I am not very much sure. Then ye question hame round 1 mein nahi karna hai. Means rejection of the question is equally important with respect to the selection of the question. Then because time is limited, time is very stipulated, how to use that time is very effective. Means you are not wasting the time. Maybe you are getting 60 minutes for DILR section, then 60 to 60 minutes you are maximum using, means 58 to 59 minutes. That much you have to improve. Generally students are using around 50 minutes. Generally, I am telling effective who are going to IIMs, who are going to top colleges, they are using 45 to 50 minutes. 10 minutes will become wastage. We don't know how it is become wastage, but 10 minutes will become wastage. If it is not productive time, means it is wastage. Then out of 60 minutes, generally 10 to 15 minutes will become wastage. Just looking the paper, seeing the question without doing anything, reading the question again, you have not selected. These are the showing your incomplete preparation. Our target is I will make you prepare, I will make you the full skilled or equipped to you. You will able to utilize out of 60 minutes, minimum 55 minutes, 55 plus minutes. Then automatically your chances of tackling the question will improve, your span of tackling the question, number of question attempt will increase, but accuracy should not come down. we have to increase your number of attempts. Together we have to decrease the time and we have to take care of accuracy. Means all these factors, if you will just put in this way, this flow diagram, then you can say these three factors are there. First is data, means data is represented in different format. The data, you have to understand how to handle the data. You have to learn so many things. How many type of tables are there? How many type of data representations are there? If data is given in percentage, then which type of technique you have to apply? If data is given in absolute number, then how you have to convert from absolute number to percentage? Or percentage, if it is given, how to convert in percentage? These all different type of technique you should learn to handle the data. Means this is your first factor. Second factor, your accuracy. Means with this difficulty of data, maybe data is given in very complicated format also, you have to keep on increase your accuracy or maintain certain level, minimum 80 to 85. Next is time. Means time, always your, during your preparation, always your target will be there. Time you should try to reduce. Means whatever your tackling time, whatever your reaction time and response time and solving time, three type of time will be there. Maybe you might be not aware, but just I'm telling you. One is reaction time, another is response time, and third is your solving time. Means any question you are taking, then first reaction will be there. Either you are able to solve or not. It is falling down in your domain or not. That is your reaction time. Second, once it is yes, okay, it is belong to algebra. Algebra is my favorite topic. I will able to solve it. Then next is coming your response time. Means after reading the question, how much time you are taking to respond. These all are the just game of brain, just communication with the brain. You are just giving the input, output should come. If input output is coming flow, this flow is very good, this flow is very smooth, automatically your time will keep on down. And afterwards will be solving time. Means the response is over. Okay, this question is based on the cubic equation. Cubic equation, we have to find the root. After that, we have to check the nature of root. This is your response. Now solving time, you have to just pick your pencil and paper and just try to solve. Okay, this is a cubic equation. This is graph. This is wavy curve nature. This root will fall down here. And after this root, it will become positive. This root will be negative. Then between positive and negative, one root will be there. The solving time, it will take some time. Then combinedly this reaction time, response time and solving time, it will be give you the time allotted or time you have given, time you invested to solve one question. Maybe it will be right or maybe wrong. If it is a right, that time is utilized. If it is a wrong, time is wasted. And afterwards you will get the negative goal also, negative marking also. Then all type of risk is there, but without risk, no life. Without risk, no life. If you are taking risk, then only chances are there you will grow. If you are not taking risk, then growth chances itself is, that root itself will be out. Root will be open if you are taking the risk. Then life will be always a risk. Either you are taking exam, either you are leaving, or either you are doing the job. Then here, time you have to keep on reduce, accuracy you have to keep on increase. Now, to encounter these three parameters, we have to understand these two challenges of DI. It's basically to do all these type of things, overall you have to gain the 98-99 percentile in DI. And overall, if I will expect, and my well wishes will be there, all of you should get 99 above the percentile overall in CAT. To encounter all these three parameters, means data, time and accuracy, we have to understand these two challenges. What are the challenges? First challenge is classification of DI caselet. That is your very first challenge. If you are not attached with the parolico.com, or you have not seen a single video on the YouTube, or you have not taken the course at the parolico.com, I think I am 100% sure any of the website or any of the teacher you go, they will not able to categorize exactly or very systematic way how many type of DI caselet is there. And that is the first path where will get the total confusion. I am telling total confusion. Means they will not able to understand which type of caselet how to solve. Just based on the practice they will keep on solve, but they are not sure which type of caselet they are capable to solve, or which type of caselet it is sure I will solve based on the certain tools or certain techniques. Then classification of DI caselet, that is most important. Means how to understand how many type of DI caselet can be framed based on the scope of the CAT syllabus. We should not go very much wayward from the CAT syllabus, because once we are jumping from the CAT syllabus or we are going out of the CAT syllabus, then you can say unlimited type of DI caselet can be there, and based on that many of the softwares are there, and you, but that is not the scope. I am telling just a scope of the preparation of CAT, how many type of DI caselet can we categorize. First thing, if you are categorizing the caselets or classifying the caselet, then based on which mathematical concept or based on any particular traits of the data you are categorizing or not, means these two things we have to take care, means representation of data and mathematical concept. Based on these two things only we have to classify the DI caselet, and this is our first challenge. And these first challenge in at paroliko.com, once you will see the further video, we have divided almost 100% of DI caselet in T1 to T8, type 1 to type 8, total 8 type of DI caselet. Almost all of your DI caselet will fall down between these T1 to T8. Means once you are seeing any of the DI caselet, like I am telling, reaction time will improve. Your response time will improve. Afterwards, how to improve your solving time? For that, second challenge is there. Everything will be taken care very scientifically, very systematically, and very, very responsive way as per the CAT exam, how to improve your CAT performance. Then classification of DI caselet, how to understand data or table. Caselet is based on which mathematical concept, means data, after then mathematical concept, and a scope of the question. Again, because same data based on the same mathematical concept, maybe question will become very difficult, that is, or maybe question will be different type, that is not a part of aptitude, or that is not a, be a part of a CAT syllabus or scope of CAT exam. Then scope of the question, that is also one of the factor. Then these three things will taken care once you are able to classify the DI caselet. Then what will happen once you are classifying the DI caselet? Your data table handling will improve, or you can say your reaction time, your response time, both will improve. Then automatically your time will reduce. That is inversely proportional, because these three time only you are using: reaction time, response time, and solving time. Out of these three time, reaction time and response time has improved. Improvements, don't think it is an increase. Time, with respect to time, improvement is always in different direction. It is improved means you are taking less time, means time is coming down. Then these two time already improved. Now only third time, how to improve, means solving time. To improve the solving time, just will take care, or just will handle the second challenge of DI, that is called for developing the tools for each type of DI caselet. Once you classify or categorize the DI caselet based on the mathematical concept or based on the representation of data, then for every type of DI caselet, which type of tool you should use, very specific. Okay, these 5 tools, these 10 tools only will be used for type 1. These 10 tools only will be used for T3 or T4. Beyond that, nothing is there. Now, don't think every question these 10 tools will be used. No, any type of caselet or any type of question based on the type 4 is based on the two variable X and Y. Any of the caselet based on the type 5 is based on the games and tournament. Then these 15 or 20 tools will be more than enough to take care any level of questions. Just be careful. Again, I am repeating the sentence. These 15 to 20 tools for each and every type of DI caselet will be enough to take care any level of questions. No need to worry. And what will happen? Your solving time will improve. What you need? You need these three things only should be encountered. Data, time, and accuracy, all are encountered based on handling these two challenges, means classification of DI caselet and developing the tools for each and every type of DI caselet. Then how to these challenges, what are the factors and what are the points we will take care, how to approach any particular type of DI caselet, means how to approach, what should be our approach. After reading the information provided in DI caselet, means what should be our ideal approach, from which point we should start and how to move. After then, tools for each type of DI caselet. Next, limitations of questions asked. That is another issue. What are the limitations? And next is method to solve any questions. Means to solve any type of question, what should be method? What should be the tools? Means once you are able to handle these two challenges, means classification or categorization of DI caselet, and second is developing the tools for each and every type of DI caselet, then what will happen? Your all three factors, time, accuracy, and data handling, all will taken care. What you need? More than that, nothing is needed. Then based on the second challenge, your accuracy will improve, time will come down. Then this is very scientific approach to understand the DI and how to improve your DI improvement, either based on the time involvement, or maybe accuracy, or maybe based on any kind of DI caselet you are capable to solve. any of the issue, you will be able to improve based on these two challenges. Then continue to learn at the rate of paroliko.com or download the mobile app. Thank you.